I would be moderately appeased if modern facilities were civilly exposed for their fraudulent villainy, phonetically spellbound, as ugly as hellhounds, a drug that could sell mouths to Venus fly traps. The only person with a possible remedy was Lassing getting strangled in a match with extremities. His mutilated corpse went on to conquer the galaxy with a $1 million suit on and his hair tied back. Meanwhile, you slurp on a bowl of udon, cursing Mother Nature for an off-key bird song. It's a minefield full of eggshells, so you better keep your shoes on. Face melts off when you swear wrong in the Grail Knight labs. Docking ants must look like tailpipes till everyone's expected to act like it's a turn on. Witches get the steak and wizards sleep on the futon. This verse is getting too long, so I'll be right back. It would be somewhat of a pleasantry if modern amenities, if only temporarily, were tested of history. Philosophers' eyes roll, thermometers rise, only monolith dipoles acknowledge grand schemes. If wisdom were reduced to commodity, the common man would contemplate his usage of honesty, and under hostage to a company policy would sputter unstoppingly his polished blasphemes. Meanwhile, you'd step on a cup of coffee made from a cheap cardboard fit for a nobody, keeping your hands busy, deepening so gaudy, infinite bland copies floating through the same stream. Mr. Insatiable, tame Leviathan, a cushion on his cranium, stadium-sized posse, radial lines beat from the base of his porta potty, lost in a daydream.